Hey, good Wednesday morning. Working on the motorhome this morning, and I got it up on cribbing, so I will flip the kit. And you can see here, I've got 6x6s, and I've got a jack stand for backup that's sitting on a board. There's not any weight on the jack stand. That's all on the cribbing there. And then I got another set of cribbing there, about halfway, and then a third set at the front. So it's pretty rock solid. It's not going anywhere. Safe to work on. And I started with the brake lines the other day, which I haven't gotten very far yet. So I removed the old brake lines. This is one of them. This is a new one that I have not installed. But it was fastened with a clip that had a bolt going through there, which I couldn't get off. So I ended up having to grind the bolt off. Same with the other side. So that's what I'm working on today, is hooking up the new brake lines, and that leads to the brake drums. The shoes aren't bad. I mean, they're not worn out completely, but this back one, which I think is the primary shoe, if I remember from my auto mechanics days, I think the back shoe is the primary shoe, and this is the secondary. I could have that backwards, but this one has more wear on it, which makes me think it's the primary, because the rivets are getting kind of close. We can see that or not. Yeah, there's not much material left before the rivets, whereas here, kind of hard to tell from the video, but with my finger I can feel the indentation, so there's quite a bit of material left on that one. But I have all new pads, I'm sorry, shoes and springs, so I'm just going to go ahead and redo everything while it's out, so I know it's good to go for many years. And also the wheel cylinder, it looks like it might be leaking a little bit, which is typical. They don't have very tight seals to begin with, but they're pretty caked up, which that kind of indicates there's some liquid there. So I'm going to change the wheel cylinder out, then hook up the new line behind it right here. The wheel bearings were greased pretty well from when I bought it. I believe they made sure all the bearings were lubed good, so, but I'm going to repack the bearings, because that's what you do when you take them apart. Here's the brake drum, and it's a combination brake drum and hub, so it's got the lug nuts attached to the front of it, and I should measure the brake drum to make sure it's not worn out. It's got a diameter of 11.090, I think that's what that says, so hopefully they're still good, and they don't really have any grooves in them to speak of, so I think they'll be fine. One thing that I did do the other day was put on these aftermarket grease fittings, and what they do, I'll show you one in a second. Okay, here's what one looks like, and it's got this copper tube, so one of the Zerk fittings is for the copper tube, and the other one is for the outside of the copper tube. So what it does is, when you grease it, one of them puts the grease right here on the end joint, and what this is a big pin, steel pin, it's like an inch and a half diameter, and it goes all the way through this part here, and that's what this part rides on, so there's friction. So that part has to stay really lubed. There's some bearings in there too. I think they're, I forgot what you call them, but like brass or bronze bearings or something. But they got to stay really lubed. So what this does is it ensures that grease gets to the back side of the bearing, the bearing that's in the back here. The original design didn't have that. So when they would lube them, a lot of times the back part of the bearing wouldn't get enough grease, and then you get bearing wear, and then the next thing you know, this whole arm is kind of loose, and it probably drove pretty poorly after that. So it's pretty cheap insurance to make sure it stays lubricated. It's great design and easy to install, so doing that, and that's pretty much it for today. I'm gonna work on this first drum assembly, new springs, new shoes, repack the bearings, and put it back on, new wheel cylinder. So stay tuned, and have a good day. We'll see you.